tells stories and the shape of the white snitches, fat men in tropical climes. Now you tell me you've been fucking King Creosote and that I should have known for a while. Watching the starlings as autumn draws in as they make ghosts across London fields, and I would have moved out there to be with you. I would have moved out there for real. Saw a choir of golden angels wearing matching rucksacks as they obscured the view to your train. And I'm sorry if it seems like I'm rambling. Cause when you see the way the skin fits round his bones and the gut and it all out, and the arms of the crowd as they pull me away, and the mud and the blood and the grass.
Chat.
Oh, the fade out. Any big pogs for the fade out? Hi, gang. Hi, everyone. Welcome to a chill stream. Really relaxed. Not really going to be doing anything productive. We're just going to be being React Andes, watching the Ubisoft Forward event today. They've been kind enough to sponsor me. And it just seems like a lovely opportunity to see what they've got in store and to chat with you guys, especially. I'm very excited to just hang with you, read chat, read out some subs and that. So we ain't do it. We're going to be doing Minecraft tomorrow, hopefully. If you're keen, we're going to be rebuilding communism. I've got some good ideas for that. So I hope you enjoy that. Anyway, 4Melon, thank you for the 3 months. Pog? 3 months, Pog, they say. Metro 420 YouTube, thank you for the 3 months as well. They say Wilbur Pog. Damn, loads of pogs today. Whale Boy, thank you for the 3 months. Hi, Will. Hi, Whale Boy. D1AMP4, thank you for the 8 months. Sleepy Twitter is in shambles right now. Help us. You did this to yourself, dude. Everyone's saying Dream. It's Dream in chat. Have I VIP'd you, Dream? Your dream was taken, aren't you? Like that. Try that. Pepsi Lexi, thank you for the 5 months. Orange Pineapple, thank you for 3 months. Is this live? Yeah. Is it live? Yes. Do you know what website you're on? Have you used this website? We're on Twitch. We're live. Ooh. Funny green guy. Yeah, that's Dream, dude. Top quality reviews, thank you for the 2 months. Azuril364, thank you for the 4 months. Hi, Will. Love you, man. Nikki was just crying about how wholesome her community is, and it made my day. Her community is very wholesome. Unlike mine. Unlike my community, where you're all little gremlins, aren't you? Look at you all. Look at them all. Look at all these little gremlins. Where are they? That way. Look at them all. They're just fiending. They're fiending at the top right of the screen at all times. You're going to be at the bottom left soon when we start the event. Look, I'm going to do it like that. Whoa! You're going to be down there. So, oh, I used to live there. Well, not in that building, but I used to live in that city. Warren 22, thank you for the 4 months. Smile. Yeah, I think. Oh no, we've got to go back to the top now. Enyo Shimas, thank you for the 8 months. Mysterious Psychology with the 3 months. You've helped me through a lot through quarantine. Thank you for giving me a reason to smile. Also, Communist Manifesto stream when? I'm not entirely sure. Communist Manifesto stream might be. I feel like it's too topical. Because that manifesto, like, kickstarted a big old thing, didn't it? And I feel like it's not my play. I don't know. I don't want to be indoctrinating people, I guess. My Rebuilding Communism video I'm going to be doing, that's going to be all, like, lighthearted. But the Communist Manifesto, it's kind of hard to make that lighthearted, you know? That's kind of there, you know? Is that just me? It's like listening to Mein Kampf probably wouldn't be a good idea, would it, on stream? So, for the same reason, even though my political opinions don't converge with either of those, I'm not going to be listening to it. Sorry. It was a silly thing to set a goal for, and I'll make it up to you with something else. Input Biscuit, thank you for the $6.31. Wait, hold on, this is live? You're on yes! We're learning what Twitch is! Pog! Oh, everyone's making it. Bro, enable better Twitch TV. No, I'm not enabling better Twitch TV. I hate better Twitch TV, dude. I hate it, man. Gomichu, thank you for $3. Hi, Wilbur. Since the Tone Deaf podcast is not happening, can we get a Sleepy Boy podcast in its place? I don't know, maybe. I don't think Techno or Phil would really be down for it, honestly, but hey ho. Chairs04, thank you for 3 months. Don't worry, you don't have to make a Communist Manifesto because it's not that funny anymore. Yeah, that's the goal. You just wait until it stops being funny. and then you carry on, dude. Addy113546, thank you for the 2 months. Twitch asked me to share, so here it is, Pog. Oh, thank you. Sweet Alien, thank you. Sweater Leon, 3117, thank you for 3 months. Watching Wilbur's got me through losing my job to COVID and having to work in the basement of Femboy Hooters. Damn, dude. A struggle, that's rough. I'm proud of you for pulling it through, dude. I'm proud of you. Zolder, thank you for the 2 months. Pink P, thank you for the 2 months. Wish Dream showed up. Yeah, but you know, I'm sure he will tomorrow. Sir Sheep with the 12 months, Pog. It's been a year. Jesus Christ. Hoping to stay here for another year. Hope you're doing good today, man. Thank you, dude. I am doing pretty good. I hope you're doing well as well. We're getting all the SMP Live boys and girls hitting a year at the moment. Because it was about a year ago I started to sort of take up SMP Live a bit more. I wasn't getting big yet, but I was growing. I think my first SMP Live, my first ever video, like a proper video when I kicked off my channel, was July 25th. So we're almost there. Yeah, and then August was when I started to pick up with Schlatt. Solithki, thank you for the 100 bits. Hi, Dad. How are you today? I'm okay. I've realized the lights in this, you know, this sort of swirling pattern you see on my screen in this office, it's giving me a headache. I'm getting like a major headache from this shit. Like it's just, and it's driving me mad. I was sitting here doing some work before the stream, and I was like, ah. So I had to go. I went outside for a bit. Now I've got to sit here for an hour. Yeah. So that's gonna be fun. Metro420YT, thank you for 3 months. 4Melon with the 3 months, and for the 5 gifted subs from 4Melon, thank you very much. Whaleboy with the 3 months. D1AMP4 with the 8 months. Thank you all very much. What's everyone? Turn the lights off. Should I try? Hold on. There's a thing, right? See this? Oh, I cleaned my bin as well. Where is it? Is it this thing? If I cover that, I think the light goes off. Eventually. Should we find a way to cover it, chat? Should we do this in the dark? Yeah! Darkness. What about, like, I think I have some sticky stuff. Hold on. I have sticky stuff. We have this. I have some toothpaste. Should we stick some toothpaste to the ceiling, chat? Pog! We'll stick this onto the ceiling and just jam it up there. Oh, I don't. Where's my sticky things? Oh, right. Right, chat. Here's the deal, chat. Right. So you see it? Hold on, how can I prop this up so you can see it? Hello! hold on. Toothpaste ceiling blocker incorporate. Right, we'll use an Evian bottle like that. There we go. There we go. Right. So you see the ceiling nipple? You see the ceiling nipple, chat? this thing. We need to cover that for the lights to go off. So if I just... So we use one of these as a command strip. They're very useful. I use them a lot. It's what's been holding clock up all these years. At least 1 year. Right? Get the toothpaste. Bam. Now we need to hold that there for a minute.
How you doing, guys? You all right down there?
And eventually...
Yay!
Toothpaste ceiling! Ceiling toothpaste! Ceiling toothpaste! Oh, ceiling toothpaste pod, guys. There we go. So now, if I'm correct, the lights should just go off in here in like a couple minutes, I think. Wait. What's that? Hold on. There's something else. Hold on. Ignore the ceiling toothpaste. I think I might have stuck the wrong thing. I think I might have stuck at the fire alarm with ceiling toothpaste. Hold on. Let me just prop this up so you can see. Oh my god. Right. Hold on. Oh my god. Is that good? There we go. Right. So, fuck. Hold on. I don't know if I'm allowed to swear. I don't know if Ubisoft have let me swear, but I think I may have done the fire alarm. Hold on. Is this the light? You don't even need a knife. There's a thing here. I don't know if you can see that. It's like a little green sensor. Fuck it. We're sticking that as well. We're getting both of them. We're getting both of them, chat. We're just all over the place. Right. I'm gonna... it could be like a carbon monoxide detector. I'm about to get us all killed. Right. Sticking this up. There we go. So both sensors are blocked. Both sensors are now blocked. Both sensors are blocked. Does anyone have a knowledge of of light fixtures? Does anyone have a knowledge of ceiling things? Is this legal? I don't know. See, even in a little chill sponsored stream, we still block out lighting. So the lights may just suddenly boop. Imagine if they turned off then. But the lights are going to suddenly turn off probably. Have you ever heard of a light switch? There isn't one. These are like sensors. We're going to figure out which light sensor is the one we need. It's a dust detector, you dusty boy. What the hell does that mean? What does that mean? Is there not a switch in here? No! We don't do switches in the United Kingdom. The Queen doesn't allow it. No, it's just this is an office building. It's all motion-activated lights. So you walk into a room. It's the same out there. Out there. You walk out into the room, and then everything goes... But I'll show you. Watch this, chat. Ready? Watch this. Light was already on out here, but you get the idea. You walk out somewhere and then the light turns on. Yeah. Bye. What do you mean? I've got the key. I'm saying bye. What do you mean? Okay. I think they're starting in 5 minutes. Scream in the hallway. No. Like, at least in here, I got the walls, right? Out there, there is nothing. It will just erupt through the entire office. We can't do that. We won't be able to do that. Hallway pog. Yeah, I know. It's a lot of you here. I'm glad you're all here. Scream. I'll scream once. Really, one really big scream. And that's all you get. 10 gifted subs for another scream. Ready? Ah! That was a cool echo. I got an echo then. Eddington Solicitors pog. He's in there. That's Eddington's. That's Eddington Solicitors. You got Mark Robinson Lawyer Solutions down there. And then you got... I still don't know their name. I could go and find out. But I don't want to get up. Scream poggers. Another 10 and I'll scream again. River Chill thing with the 2 months. Exo Nelly OX with the $3.79. I don't really know how to word this without being awkward. I am now 1 month and 16 days clean. Pog! Honestly, can't thank you enough for making the process a little easier. You and your community made me the happiest I've ever been. Dude, Pog. I'm so happy for you. I'm so glad. And remember, I've said this before, but remember, even if you stumble or you slip back, just remember this progress you've made can't go away. That's with you forever, this progress. So I believe in you. You can go even further. Jules the Jewel 18, thank you for the 2 months. Beans 165, thank you for the 2 months. Poggers, Abby Allen with the 2 months pog. Epic 224358 with the 400 bits, not like this. Here's some money for you, Soot Smugs. Thank you, bruh. Bizarre Duck, thank you for the 3 months. Yeah, they say. Pasta Big with the 100 bits, thank you very much. Fireball 745, thank you for the 2 months pog. Zalexa, thank you for the 8 months. 8 months poggers, thank you for doing what you're doing. By the way, I cannot stop listening to your album. I love it a lot. Thank you. I love you a lot. Sir Strawberry, thing with the 2 months. Leaf Boy, thing with the 100 bits. Yo, Wilbur, I hope you're doing well. Just wondering if you still plan on posting MCC content on your YouTube channel. Yes, if we win. If we win the next one, I will post MCC content. Otherwise, I'm out. If we don't win the next one, I'm gone. I'm out of that tournament. This is my make or break, dude. The Sky Starler, thing with 100 bits. Oscar Ramden, 124, thank you for the 200 bits. Love you. I thought it was going to be something rude. I'm sorry. Richard, thank you for the $5. Hey, Mr. Soot, can you rebuild Christianity one stream? No! Can you imagine the comment section? Holy shit, Richard, I love you for the suggestion, but man, can you imagine the comment section if I tried to build any religion? Hello, yes, today we're doing Islam in Minecraft. Just no religions, no religions. Warren22, thank you for the 200 bits. Barrister, thank you for the 2 months. Hope Ubisoft show Hacker Granny again. Yes! Yes! If Hacker Granny comes on screen, it probably will. It was so big last time. Well, but just a quick question, what's that? Will you ever do a stream with someone else from the office? I think that'd be cool to introduce them to us gremlins. I don't know anyone else in the office. I could go and... Oh... That'll be the next sub goal. After this one, I'll go and find someone in this office and get them on stream with us. That'll be the next goal. After the ghost hunt, we'll go and find someone from the office. Sketchalicious thing with 100 bits. Hi, Wob, your content's really got me through. I'm really sorry. I've got to quickly do this because we have to start the thing soon. So, your content's really got me through quarantine and you've got me back into Qatar after 3 years not playing it. Thank you so much for everything. The album is pogus. Thank you, Sketchalicious. I appreciate it. Sammy Witch with the 3 months. Croissant Sauce with the 8 months pog. Hello, fine day for a wouldn't you say it is a fine day for a Kevin BB thing with the 2 months. Octamin with the 2 months. Lanz Verida with the 3 months. I'm sorry if I've missed anyone, but I would like to say, how weird is it the lights are still on? I thought I did that pretty well. I think we're starting.
Yes, was laughing. Oh! When they really hit something that felt like the game industry.
Wait, is that 21 minutes? Brilliant. Wait, is it at 20 past 8? Is it at 20 past 8? And I've been given the wrong time? Is my YouTube just behind? I think my YouTube's just behind. Hold on. Yes, 1 minute, 1 minute, here we go, okay. Oh, I thought I'd messed up. My stream was behind, it's fine. Swimfellow with the 5 gifted subs, you get a little yelp for that. That people want me to yell. Yeah, yell it, go on, TikTok man.
But I can't usually do it because I'll freak out my neighbours. But, as you can see, I'm at the crashing ocean.
Oh, you're so cool, TikTok man.
No one too close, so. Reloading! Someone saw me. I gotta go.
I don't believe you. I don't think anyone saw him. I'm gonna put it out there. I don't think anyone saw him. He's a little bit of a... a little bit of a porky! Oh! This haven't even started. I'm having a great time. Is it too loud for you guys? Is it a good volume or... Wilbur shut. Alright, fine. Good. TikTok man pog, dude. She was fucking good. Did someone say feet
pog? If you also have amazing gameplay segments you captured from our games, spread the joy and submit them on the link.
I don't think I've ever played an Ubisoft game on stream, have I?
Time for us to wrap up this pre-show.
Don't forget to stay tuned from our post
Thank
show
you.
Featuring a deep
Thank you.
I'm Assassin's Creed
Valhalla. Thanks a lot for watching this pre-show.
Should I have been watching the pre-show? 10, 9. Oh, look at the budget. I need this. I'm not too quiet. It's too quiet, you say. Oh, sorry. This is Ubisoft.
Explore our world. Meet the devs. See the games.
Not swipe, I think, is $4. Lost a bet to a friend, was gonna have to donate to Pokimane Illinity. Would rather send it to you. Thank you, man. Is that good? Is that good price? A good price? Good volume.
Hi everyone, I'm Neelam Kumar, and
hi Neelam Kumar!
Hosting the first Ubisoft Forward with the talented Yusuf Magid.
Yeah, Yusuf!
Today's show is all about getting up close and in depth with all the exciting games we have in production here at Ubisoft.
I'm Yusuf, but there's no
Yusuf! Can we get Yusuf so Pog? Yusuf Pog in the chat.
Futuristic London. And see what the hackers of DedSec are getting into.
I was set in London. Oh, I'll be a good judge of this chat. I lived there for 3.5 years.
The illegal paintings spreading subversive and
that's Piccadilly, innit?
The last few weeks across London are not the work of several people as was originally believed, but the work of an individual. The criminal suspected to have links with the terrorist.
That's my favourite off license. Don't wreck up my favourite off license, mate. Wow, they actually have English voice actors. I'm gonna say now, pet peeve of video games is shit British voice actors. You know, like the what's that? Cheers, love. The cavalry's here and stuff. It's awful. If this has good voice actors, I'll be happy. That's Liverpool Street Station. That is.
Then they came for the protesters.
He hasn't got a London accent.
I did not speak out. I was not a protester.
Shut up, Wilbur Pog. Be quiet then.
Then they came for the journalists. And I did not speak out. Because I was not a journalist.
Wait, isn't this that saying from like... Isn't gonna be and then they came for us and no one was here to defend us.
But I did not speak out.
Wait, I swear this is the
because I am not a street artist.
But then they came for me and there was no one else left to protect me. That's the isn't that like that's a bit that just I don't want to say what I think it's from, but yeah, someone in chat says what I think it is. You're right, yeah, that suit is from World War II, yeah, I'm pretty sure. World War II plagiarism, someone said. No. In case you're wondering, that's actually what the buses look like. That's not futuristic. They do have those little curvy windows at the front. They're really cool. I like them a lot.
I like the buses a lot.
Wilbur's a poem.
Come for me, and there would be no one left to speak for me.
World War II poggers! That's not a poggers moment. World War II was not poggers. World War II poems, though, pretty poggers. You want me to put it? You want me to make it bigger? I'll make it bigger, chat. Chat, you're going behind it. Screw you, chat. Nah. Sorry, miss! Is that better, chat? Is that better? Is that better, chat? You happy?
After a long night, London is in chaos. The main arteries through the city are blocked. Hundreds of heavily armed Albion.
Well. Welcome to the resistance. There's a welcome.
I've been in that pub. I know that pub. That's near Tottenham Court.
You could have told me it was a bloody costume party.
I've been in this pub.
The new key suspect has been identified as David Ford, a 43-year-old London taxi driver. He has no criminal record, but is currently believed to be a terrorist. People have been asked not to approach him. The authorities advise all residents.
Why is his nostrils? Cool. I like it. I always thought Watchdog was a really cool idea, but like they like there was like that famous Watchdog 1 fiasco.
So yeah, what we just saw was an amazing short film by the director.
Second one was good though.
That was inspired by Watch Dogs Legion.
Nose Pog!
Looks at the game and the universe and the characters through his incredible
Red Coral, thank you for the 2 months.
Vision and visual
style. Red Liqueur, thank you for the $4.20. This is the first time watching your live like because your stream schedule is bad. I love you though. My stream schedule's fine for me.
Setting aside their differences in order to come together as a collective and to fight for a positive change. You can literally recruit and play anyone who you see in the open world. You profile people that are interesting to you. You help them with their problem. You play their origin mission.
Just help me get some closure and I'll do whatever you want.
Sounds like a DedSec problem. Leave it to us.
And that's how you recruit them into your team. And then they become the heroes of the game and the stars of your story.
And what are you doing in my flat? You with Albion?
Are they like procedurally generated then? Or are they all like designed with like stories and that?
I'm tickled, but think more underground.
What, DedSec? Yeah, right, and I'm Che Guevara. You're done.
The key to a good schedule is no schedule.
You know, unique to them, but unique to you as the player and personal to you. Because
I don't like how this American man's got a Union Jack badge on, but missing the Northern Ireland cross.
Take care of yourselves, stay safe. Welcome to the Resistance.
He is. That was missing the North... I don't know. Maybe it's a statement. That's a modern bus.
Built on history.
That's not a real car. That's the Gherkin does not have ads spinning around it. Can you imagine?
To tear it all down.
It's Tower of London. Oh no, it's not. Is that some pulls? There's some pulls.
Get all your units to move in and lock down the city.
Dude, honestly, if they've recreated London, I am hyped for that.
Under attack by a mysterious terrorist. The government turns to a private military company called Albion to keep everyone safe. What could possibly go wrong? Ladies and gentlemen,
Libri.
Mr. Nigel Cass, CEO of Albion. He's kindly
Wilbur in Watch Dogs. Put me in, coach.
Understand this. I will not allow anyone, not even myself, to jeopardize this.
He will stop at nothing to permanently control the city.
So America. How is it America? To be made truly safe. America, not everything's about you, all right? Please.
Nigel's not the only opportunist who's taken a liking to this fair city. Meet Mary Kelly, head of the most powerful crime...
Is this Hacker Granny?
Be sure and spread the word.
Hacker Granny?
She and her goons are using the dark web to sell everything.
The dark web?
To people.
Microchip is scary, I know, but I got to keep tracks on my merchandise tonight.
It's not Hacker Granny.
You made me a slave.
You do not want to ruffle her feathers.
Grim.
With the city out on its ass, it now falls on you to build a resistance and take back London.
All right, everyone. Faces on, guns out.
Any of the brave Londoners you see.
Why don't we just stop paying taxes?
Can be recruited.
Let's just stop. Just stop paying taxes. You don't have to fight like a private military. Just don't pay taxes. Then what? What are they gonna do?
Or even her.
What are they gonna do, man?
Everyone could become your next secret weapon. In our first mission, we need to get some dirt on Nigel Cass, and that means breaking into Albion headquarters inside the Tower of London.
Why have they set it up in the Tower of London? Hold on. That's not a good place. I bet there's crap Wi-Fi in there.
They have unique abilities, and you're free to tackle this mission with whoever you like.
Oh, it's the Shard. I love the Shard.
Zip up, get to work, and let's never talk about this again.
See, city, London city there.
Like everyone in
DedSec, do you have a license to pee in the river, mate?
Pretty much whatever. But as a construction
worker, Callum, how are you?
A particular set of tools that make him handy.
Well, he's just beating. He's just beating someone with a wrench.
Call his own cargo drone.
Literally beating someone with a wrench.
Perfect for gate crashing. When you're
how
not
you
invited.
Doing, Callum? Apparently, I missed the
and
hacker
who needs
granny. What?
A regular old gun when you have a bloody nail gun.
Well, I mean, you're against a private military. I'd want a real gun. Beat him with a wrench, Pog! Beat him with a wrench, Pog!
Perhaps we could approach this mission differently. if you'd rather keep your distance, we've got you covered. Amy is a drone expert.
Oh, this is the not wrench
the real
one.
Tech connoisseur.
Oh, we don't want the not wrench one. Only wrench pog for us, please. Beat him with a wrench pog. I like that spelling of wrench someone's done. Hold on. Let me just read out how this person has spelt the word wrench. W-R-E-N-C-K-H. Wrench. Wrench.
This little darling is fast and stealthy.
She aims, she fires, she hits.
He missed Hacker Granny but mistook Margaret Thatcher for her. Margaret Thatcher is dead, alright? Don't forget that.
She can also hack enemy drones.
I wish I was a tech connoisseur. Why is the Gherkin got ads on it?
If you're not into direct confrontation, there are more ways than one to get the job done. Recruiting an Albion officer like Brielle here might be challenging, but it'll get you inside restricted Albion areas.
Don't mind. I do like Ubisoft's like open world, like taking down whichever way you want kind of vibe.
Suspicious, and she'll probably wind up with
just
a
hope it's as good as Watch Dogs
2.
Wrench Pog! Wrench Pog!
We're missing the human element here. I can get the defense minister on the line.
God,
right,
so
now.
Many English accents here.
If you must.
I swear to God, if I hear a single American putting on a British accent, though, I'm gonna make fun of them. I swear to God.
Criminals running our streets, illegals threatening our families, the police commissioner.
That voice
himself
does not match this man.
Assassinated by terrorists.
Well, that seems to be enough evidence. Next up, we're crashing Mary Kelly's organ farming operation.
Oh, South Bank! Oh, Deptford! I used to live there! Pog! I used to live where that zoomed in! Deptford!
And we need
there
a
was a shooting near
this.
My house.
Impairing our frontal lobe again, are we?
Benny, thank you for the 3 months, dude. Beast of East, thank you for the 2 months. Ogblia, thank you for the 5 months. Team.
That put another air on my chest.
And doesn't mind getting his hands
That's
dirty.
Not where Deptford is. Oh, that literally looks like... that looks like where I used to live. This area looks pretty accurate, except for the Big Ben. Big Ben wasn't near there.
He does have
copyright
a
free punk music.
Drinking problem, though. And he's passed out. Ah, well, we'll come back to him. You know what? Let's go with someone a bit more professional.
Also in Deptford? We did it, chat! The lights are off! Alright, now it's mood. Now it's mood.
Crass to call him a hitman.
The lights are off! We did it! Dark Pog. Dark Pog. Here we go. Cheers. After this, we'll find out which one of the ceiling things is the sensor.
Some might even call him an artist.
I wouldn't. But that's just me, you know? What do I know? Benny also says, hi Will, I think you're cool. Thank
Here's
you,
the bastard responsible.
Bro, your teeth are so white you can see them. They're not
Done
that white.
And dusted.
Yeah, they're a little bit white. I have to have good teeth so that people don't think
not
English people are bad
London
teeth.
Is a legendary assassin or a super spy,
no.
But everyone can be a hero.
Just like me. Fake teeth. So fake Elodie, get out of here with your lies. I'm gonna demod Elodie. Hold on.
It's time to take back London.
Look, I'm not gonna demod you, Elodie. Elodie, it was in Deptford. They did a bit in Deptford, Elodie. It was like right on my house.
Breathing city, teeming with unique locales and characters. Has always been a central pillar of the Watchdogs.
Clock does glow.
So what goes into building those worlds? Here's Amanda Mutt to tell us more.
Amanda Pog! Wait, is that Amanda?
My name's Amanda Mutt. I'm a level artist on Watchdogs.
You could have left the bike outside, I think, honestly. I think you could have left
Being
the bike outside.
Being a level artist, I think, is the coolest job in video games because we do get the freedom to kind of like pick and choose what little details we want to depict.
They couldn't give you a nice webcam mount, though.
Tell the stories that we want to tell.
Look at her webcam mount. Everyone laugh.
I have the capacity to hide things and, you know, like small little Easter
eggs. Come on, Ubisoft, please give her a tripod.
Unity,
Ubisoft, please.
There was a boat somewhere in the world that was covered in cats. And then it happened again in Watch Dogs 2. And there may or may not be something in London that is a boat filled with cats in some capacity.
I know. I put them there. Don't worry, Amanda. I'm on the case. Last year,
some of the people that I was showing our demo to were from London. So no matter where I dropped them.
People from London?
Oh my God, this feels like Camden. This, you know, this feels like Southwark. This feels like Westminster.
Westminster?
When people are talking about some detail that I've put into the world and they're excited about it, like that feels so good.
Genuinely, this does look cool. I'm taking the mick, but it does look cool. It does actually, that did look a lot like Camden. I was gonna make fun of it and then it actually did look like Camden. London does not exist.
And now some news for Brawlhalla fans.
Yeah.
In just a few weeks, you'll be able to battle it out with your favorite legends on iOS and Android devices.
Was that Yusuf? That was Yusuf, wasn't it? Thank you, Yusuf! If that's your name, I may have got you confused. London is fake. Get out of here.
3, 2, 1, brawl!
Let's do a Watch Dogs 1 in Brighton, dude. The bike is not necessary. Yeah, Amanda. Sort it out. I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't know what this is. Oh, it's like a stage fighter. Is that Finn from my favorite cartoon show, Adventure Time? They put Jake and Finn from my favorite cartoon show, Adventure Time. You register now. I think my face cam's blocking an important part. Oh, it's just a bear, don't worry.
Whether you need a Tom Clancy action fix on the go, I want to dive back into one of the most beloved fantasy franchises.
Slough Watch Dogs, asks Farrington. Maybe do. Thank you for the 100 bits, Farrington. It has been a great... Has it been a great 7 months? I've just been inside and depressed for 7 months, but maybe it's been good for you, Ubisoft. Thank you, guys. Please turn your lights on. No, I like it. I like this. I like just my face being illuminated. Okay.
The target is being held on the ground floor.
Run! Shoot! Is that the GIG? Is that the French counter-terrorist force? What are they doing here? What game is this, chat? Chat, give us some games. I don't think it's Overwatch. I don't think they'd be happy with that. Rainbow Six. Rainbow Six, but mobile, someone says. Maybe. It's not Fortnite. These are not Ubisoft games. You're gonna get me fired. I'm not gonna get my sponsorship if you keep saying games that aren't Ubisoft. They will come. They're gonna break in this door and kill me. Rainbow Six, probably, yes. I've never played Rainbow Six, so I wouldn't know if any of the characters look like cartoony versions of themselves. That's the Splinter Cell man.
Hey, take this.
Don't make me regret this.
That's not right. Chat! You guys lied to me. It's Tom Clancy's Elite Squad. You guys said it was right. I don't know. I've never played them.
Speaking of Tom Clancy, it's been 5 years since Rainbow Six Siege first.
There it is! You can't beat
in
me.
Celebration of this milestone,
I forgot
Ubisoft
your name,
Montreal
but thank you. What's her
video.
Name? Chat,
they
what's her name? I forgot her name.
Players and developers that have helped Siege become the game it is today.
Rainbow Six. Are we going to see my man, General Sam, in this? I don't think they'd let him on.
In December 2015, a small team released Rainbow Six Siege.
Where's my code?
A game built on a strong vision. Creativity,
sorry,
competitiveness,
Mr. Six.
And team play.
Pour le joueur, le 1er décembre, c'est un début, mais pour nous aussi. Il faut tout de suite s'engager et dire au joueur, ce jeu est installé, tu peux t'y installer aussi, et nous serons
là. That original vision was quickly adopted by our passionate community, propelling it to a whole new level.
I just realized that, whilst me sitting in the dark is very hard. The air conditioning just turned on to full.
They just turned the air conditioning on to full, and I only realized when I started to feel so cold, and it's July.
Stronger than ever, and more players today than we had in the past. It means the world to us.
But we also had our share of challenges.
Health that touches upon subject like matchmaking, connectivity, all those aspects are absolutely
critical. Hey, nice clock. Oh, they said cock.
The
okay. That's a clock.
Play.
Wrong.
Through it all, we're
French
always
Pog,
driven
eh?
by you.
It's French Canada, isn't it? Ubisoft.
And together,
I don't know.
We grow stronger.
I'm not here to be making assumptions. You want to hug me,
no
says T1 Toke. Well, too
years.
Bad. I'm behind security guards in an office. You can try. Try and hug me.
Look at this.
Don't try and hug me. I will cry and run.
Tous les succès, c'est vraiment le résultat de autant de nous que de vous. Ce jeu, il est autant le vôtre.
I don't know what that is. I don't speak
now,
that language.
Now 60 million players strong, we're just getting started.
Scott says, can I hug you? Scott, you can hug me, but only once the frightful virus has gone, Scott.
Thank you.
Andrew Boy from 69, thank you for the 5 months. Hey, this is Pog, very Pog. I like Yes 5, Big 5, yay. Thank you, Andrew Boy from 69, thank you for the 5 months. So Lucy says 100 bits. Can we see Home Home?
Yet,
yes, you can.
Dive into our new Operation Steel Wave update available now. And take
Neelam!
Lucy
Neelam! Hello, Neelam. Look, guys,
ago,
sub.
We introduced y'all to
sub,
a
it's the thing you like.
Shooter.
Sub to me.
Now, it's time to venture.
Yusuf! I keep forgetting the other one's name. Fuck. What's her name? Knee something? Oh, I'm bad at names. We love Yusuf, though. I remember Yusuf, right? Is this another one set in Europe? Is this set in Paris now? Oh, it's Hyperscape. I know Hyperscape.
What was that? A hack in a Hyperscape. That's
oh,
not
it's a Hyperscape,
to be
sorry.
Well, let me get you all up to speed, okay? About 30 years ago, everything that we feared about our future started to come true.
Think of it, 1,000 bits, Dynomite. Is that for Home Home? Again, more.
Actually, we made a lot of that.
Lovey, you think we have 3 months.
So, here we are.
2054.
10 million souls living in
oh, the world's still around. Places. Cool, I thought we'd all be dead by then. But Dynamite keeps giving me 100 bits. Thank you, Dynamite. Dynamite, that's the $6 you've given me now.
They gave everyone a way out. The Hyperscape.
Oh, it's like the film.
The biggest draw by far is Crown Rush. This is where anyone can become someone.
Battle Royale game! Is this set in Paris or London or where in Europe is this set? Where's Rainbow Seven Siege? The triangle, generic European city. Yes, for now, until we see a landmark.
If you get good at Crown Rush, it can change your life. But strange things have been happening lately. Rumors of people getting hurt.
Oh, it's Paris. The big obelisk. It's the big Parisian,
users
big Parisian archway. What's it called?
World?
The Arc de Death? Arc de Mort.
A darker secret lies at the heart of Hyperscape.
Fuck, what's the anime where they get stuck in the game? Someone said that. I even know that, and I don't watch anime. That's,
some of us are searching
thingy.
For a way out.
David, if you're here, say it. It's
some
the one.
Some of us for a way out. And for others, a new way all
move
together.
The mouse, oh yeah.
That's what brings us to the edge of the future. To the hyperscape.
Sword Art Online, that's the one. Hyperscape. Is this like RuneScape, but hyper?
JC's work on Far Cry.
There you are, Nee. I need to remember her name. It's Nee something.
Him as a top creative here at Ubisoft.
For me, what's exciting is we started.
JC! JC! JC Pog! JC Poggies!
Hello, contender. Welcome to the Hyperscape.
The game takes place in 2054. It's in a future where humanity has grown a little darker. One of the companies
a little.
There, they are launching what's called the Hyperscape. Which
JC
is
Poggy's voice!
It's the place where everything converges. Within the virtual world, there is a battle royale that takes place in the virtual city.
Swim
photo,
think of the $5. Home Home deserves a home home, or here he is on your screen again! Whoa! This is the sub to me sign. When you see this, it's time to
then
subscribe to Wilbur Soot.
A lot of new things.
I am joking, by the way. It's a joke. Nikki Raid! Hi, Nikki's viewers! We're watching JC Poggies discuss his game he's been working on, where the world is a little darker.
Items, but also more players, so it's a risk-reward kind of deal.
Yeah, yeah. Punch the floor. Look up dramatically.
Hacks, special abilities that you can pick up on the fly to adapt your tactics. With hacks, you can do things like teleport.
Hi, Nikki's viewers. How are you? Apparently, Nikki got emotional. Couldn't be me. You won't see me getting emotional here today.
So
thank you for the sub, Smickle9. Here's Home Home. If you like Home Home, sub.
Toys that you can play with.
Yeah, you won't see me getting emotional. Don't worry, guys. I'm not like that.
It's made as a spectacle, so all the viewers will be able to interact with the game on different levels through the Twitch extension.
Cool.
So every few minutes, there's going to be a vote, and viewers will be able to.
Oh, that's my job. I'm a content Twitch creator.
Things like changing the gravity, infinite ammo, or stuff like that. So players, while this happens, really have to adapt.
They're just going to do this. They're going to find something and just do it over and over again. I know they're just going to find something that's like that's like unbearable to play with, and they're just going to keep doing that. Home Home is overrated, says Stankoey. Well, you're wrong. Here he is again. Whoa! Thank you for the 2 months, Finny Magic, with the Home Home Prime. Thank you.
And all the viewers who participated in tech test and who will participate in the open beta. Here's a short glimpse of what you can expect.
Jumping, sword, running, sliding, sliding, movement mechanics. Home Home is my wife. No, he's not. Get out of here. That was the same. Are we seeing the same footage again? Oh no, but this is different now.
Let's show him what I made.
Wilbur's sense of emotion is the same as his sense of humor. Get right, ban him, ban him. Get him out of my chat. I'm funny. Haha. Look, funny sign. Catchphrase. Woo! I am so funny. Haha. Woohoo! Yeah!
Watch closely.
Thomas Nook, 69, I think they're 3 months. French, they say. French, yes, that was a French person, I assume. You are correct. Yes, chat. Funny! Funny man! Funny Wilbur! Haha! Shut up, man. Okay, so, wow, fuck. Dude, I'll stop being funny for you. Jesus. Wilbur, I'm not gonna read that one. Four
the
melon with 100 bits, funny.
Yusuf! Incredible freedom when it came to designing.
I think
characters.
I was hoping that would be
Production
Yusuf's name coming up.
Anna Maria Muska is going to take us behind the scenes of character design.
My name is Anna Maria Muska.
Hello,
I'm
Anna Maria.
The production manager for characters and weapons on Hyperscape. We have paid an exceptional amount of detail to our characters.
Anna Maria is a cool name. Anna Maria is a really cool
name. Different fashion statements, different tattoos, different materials.
Wilbur, please, we want to listen. I'm sorry, but I'm just such a little reactor. I love to react.
In game, you understand what their motivations are and what drives them and what challenges them. This was the
Let's see if I can be quiet for this one. Let's see if I can be quiet.
This is our default base, but even starting from the hair down, everything has been meticulously thought of. Would this person actually like this type of outfit? Would this person enjoy the type of tattoos that we're putting on them? Will they actually like to be in this body?
I want to say
each season we plan to produce new outfits for these characters. So we're hoping some of our players are gonna see the effort and maybe even correlate some of the accessories to.
Nikki says, "What game is this?" Nikki, it says at the top right of the screen. God, open your eyes.
To see it in people's hands.
It's Hyperscape, Nikki. Nikki, my dear.
As we move into the next generation of gaming,
we want Yusuf. We want Yusuf
to take advantage of all the extraordinary capabilities these new consoles will offer.
Now we have a special guest to tell us a little more.
Who is it? Me? What? So how? What would you say if it was me?
Phil Spencer from Xbox.
Hi.
With Watch Dogs Legion,
I don't know who this
Ubisoft is.
Is
supporting smart delivery. So you will get the absolute.
What would you
best
guys do if it was me? What would you guys do if it was like a special guest and it was just me?
You're playing on. On Series X, you'll get to take advantage of the amazing
Phil Pog.
The team
is Phil here.
DirectX ray tracing to create an
absolute. Oh no, Phil's the name of the guy. Okay.
London, like you've never seen before.
Yeah, let's get some Phil Pogs, but don't make me think Phil's a drink.
Unique ability to create immersive worlds, setting a new bar that continues to drive our industry forward. I'm a huge fan of Assassin's Creed. I love the time I've spent exploring the world in Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
Good.
And I can't wait for you to see the gameplay from Assassin's Creed Valhalla that's coming up now.
All right. We know you've been waiting to hear more about this game.
Yusuf, stop teasing us.
And now it's time for a deep dive into the world of Vikings.
Hurry up, Yusuf. We want to see.
My name is Julien Laferrière, and I'm the producer of Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So a couple of weeks ago, we announced Assassin's Creed Valhalla and the reaction from the fans.
Julien Pog!
The time period
Julien Pog! Shush Pog, okay,
really inspiring.
Fine.
When we did our research, we found that, you know, they were not mindless barbarians. Vikings were actually farmers trying to find new lands for them to settle. And so they had really human motivations. So for us to have this opportunity to tell kind of the real story about Vikings and kind of separate ourselves from the myths and the folklore is really something that drove us to make this game. The team went to Norway and England.
Oh, by the way, if you've been watching and you've got your Ubisoft account linked with your Twitch, you've unlocked a bunch of stuff. If you look below the stream, there's all the drops that are on for this stream.
And then leaving Norway, which is barren but majestic, and just coming by boat in England,
yay!
See those rolling green hills full of
seagulls.
Sheep, full of life, is just this moment that most likely the Vikings felt as well. You need to see this land of opportunity. And this is exactly the feeling we want players to experience in this game.
Yeah. So you want to simulate invading my country?
It is a personal adventure, you know? It is the story of Eivor, a Viking chieftain. Eivor is either a male or a female. You decide when you start.
I mean,
the
that
game.
Ignores the many murders. They yeah, the Vikings did
Norway
do a lot of murdering.
In England because you just can't
that
live
was
in
kind
Norway
of their thing,
anymore.
Wasn't
There's
it?
Too much political pressure, no resources available.
Wait, is this going to be one of those games where the British are the bad guys? Why are we
Obviously
always the bad guys?
England,
the British invaded more, bro. I know, but
people,
I'm allowed to hold a grudge.
So you will have to fight your way there to kind of build your own settlement and see your clan.
Izai, thank you for the $3. Well, bro, I love your biz. Been watching for a while. Have a good day, man. Thank you, dude. You too.
Vikings were brutal warriors.
Mm-hmm.
Shields!
And the fact that they were mastering a lot of weapons coming from the medieval
Hashtag
times
fuck the British.
Really inspired
yeah.
us to kind of...
I mean, yeah, I'm fully
the
aware
system.
The British are bad. But the Vikings are still... This was before we were bad, I assume. This is when we were just farmers and stuff.
Vikings were not only fighting face to face, they were masters of stealth and deception when needed.
The British invaded everyone. What do you mean, why are you guys the bad guys? Okay, maybe we deserve
to win
it.
The battle. So we
okay,
want to
maybe we deserve
the full
it.
Range
yeah, sure.
of combat that you can imagine coming from the Vikings.
Oh, he's got the hidden blade.
We are very happy to finally be able
Brits
to show
are all assholes.
All
wow, it's a wow, we're going
enjoy this deep dive into Assassin's Creed Valhalla.
Yo, Wilbur, how was pizza? It was good. It was good. Fuck the British. I like this. I like the Anglophobia in the chat, guys. It comes out when, for some reason, when Vikings are on the screen.
You play as Eivor, a Viking from Norway, who will lead his or her battle-hardened warriors across the North Sea to the British Isles.
Yeah.
Eivor is driven by an ambitious goal, to build a thriving Norse settlement in a hostile land.
See, I like all these people saying fuck the British in the chat, but they've all subbed. So they can say, if you've subbed, you can say whatever you want about me. knock yourselves out.
England is a dark age tangle of broken kingdoms and warring dynasties. A land of opportunity and riches.
Okay, so we haven't been the bad guys yet. Soon, though, soon we will be bad guys, I assume.
You may raid locations.
I don't know, my engineer's just not very good.
Ground your ship and blow your horn to lead your raiding crew into battle.
TOS? I love the British because I am one, someone said. Yeah, I don't think that.
Your crew will assist you.
Yeah, burn down Slough! Burn down Slough!
Battering down doors. And stealing cargo too heavy for one set of arms. Whatever riches and resources you pillage may be used to develop your settlement, giving you access to useful services, better tools, and new settlers.
At the heart It'd be cool if you could like build the houses and shit. That'd be really cool. I like building and that.
Record of the allies you have made.
Oh my god, Burn Slough is being held by mods.
The Viking Age was a time of warriors.
Burn Slough Kiss wasn't there.
In Valhalla,
Burn Slough Kiss wasn't being held.
The largest variety of enemies ever assembled in an Assassin's Creed game. Every archetype offers a unique challenge. Some will coordinate with their allies for special attacks, while others will use nearby objects to their advantage, including the bodies of fallen warriors. To face these attacks, you must find and exploit your opponent's weaknesses to gain the upper hand. Take the fight to your foes with a host of brutal new combat abilities. Snare them with a Viking harpoon.
Bloody hell! He's ripped his fucking head off!
Incapacitate them with the new stun system to keep them at a distance, or finish them off. Dual wield any two weapons you wish to unleash a deadly combination of attacks. Customize your fighting style as you see.
He's not even got armor on. He's just a dude.
Viking warrior.
I want to see how they incorporate the assassins part into this. That'll be interesting. Because this just looks like fighting. Wield,
including two shields.
Do you think it's still sneaky assassins, or is it just like gung-ho assassins now?
Not all situations call for violence.
Hey! Well, I'm clairvoyant! Home? Sub for home.
As Eivor is not welcome in England, you may need to outsmart your enemies, avoiding unwanted attention in towns and bustling cities.
Bread Pog! Do you think that's actually her dough, or is she just like needing it? Among the people. Steffi Lol, thank you for the $2. So there are some rewards based on watch time. Do they count if we watch your stream? If we're the accounts linked, of course. I believe so, yeah. I think if you're watching any stream that I've got my drops on for this, so if you're watching any stream with that, then it should work.
Keeping yourself sharp. You must feed off the land if you hope to endure.
Joe Biden, thank you for the 200 bits. Fortify your equipment.
Search pagan temples and Roman ruins for new
drops for what? If you look under the what's it called? The stream. Just scroll down under the stream, you should see a list of the drops depending on how long you've been watching.
The more you explore, the more of England's secrets you will reveal.
You need to have your account linked with Ubisoft then.
Ravens, show no mercy!
But as you push deeper into England, the enemy will
Did the dog
back.
Die? I was talking, I didn't see the dog die. Okay, I'm glad I didn't see the dog die. That would have made me sad.
Valhalla will feature massive assaults in which you
The login is broken, so they said everyone will get it. Okay, there you go.
Against heavily guarded Saxon fortresses.
Today, we will reclaim her. Today, we fight for your land. And tomorrow, we rebuild. For
Istanbul. They don't sound very Norwegian.
Assassin's Creed Valhalla will transport you to wondrous and haunted lands, inspired by Norse myths and England's pagan roots. It will challenge and surprise, with unforgettable characters, thrilling triumphs, and tragic losses.
I do love how xenophobic everyone's getting in the chat. Like,
live your own Viking saga.
It's just a video game, man. Move the mouse. Ooh. I'm like a teacher who like doesn't understand computers. Because I don't. I really don't get them. I'm doing a video at the moment where I'm building my new PC. You guys are going to love that. I'm just a mess. I'm so bad at computers and stuff.
9th century England is truly unlike anything the franchise has seen before. Assassin's Creed Valhalla will release this holiday season on Xbox Series X, PlayStation 5,
Yusuf, Xbox you're out of sync.
PS4, PC, and Stadia.
Yusuf, you're out of sync!
We're close to wrapping up today, but before we go,
wait,
our CEO, Yves
Broken?
Guillemot, is here to share a few words.
Broken Pog?
I hope you will have enjoyed...
Is this Broken Pog? Out of sync Pog? Hold on, let me refresh. There we go. It was just me. Don't worry, they didn't break anything. Yusuf was out of sync, but that's fine.
Lineup of games.
Will, I can't log in. I know. Check their Twitter. They're talking about it on Twitter. On Ubisoft's Twitter.
We have a lot more.
I think too many people are trying to get on.
So you will have another Ubisoft forward.
Esme is not okay. Thank you for the $1. Hello, Wilbur. I hope you're doing all right. Thanks for the legendary games. Streams and the cool album. You've inspired me to start playing the guitar. Pog, do you have any tips for starting out? Learn 4 chords and then just keep practicing songs you enjoy. Wolfclaw Gaming, thank you for the 2 months. Boat. More boats. Lots of boats. Giancarlo Pog! That looked cool. I like that. That was cool. Is this Far Cry? Is this actually Far Cry? This is the one that I'm most genuinely interested in, like most definitely very interested in Far Cry. I played so much Far Cry 2 and Far Cry 3. Didn't play much Far Cry 4, but I love the colors, dude. Dude, whoever's the color grader and editor on this, man, good job. Patrick Clare, you did a good job. Color theory. Oh, nice. Excited, dude. I'm a huge Far Cry fan, man. Thanks to my dad more than anything.
It's beautiful, Milo. Perfect, but useless. I have something for you, Diego. Give me your hands.
Looks like Gus Fring from the back, from Bubba. Breaking Bad.
The grenade is simple.
It isn't it? That's the parts. Face actor.
The shell, which contains the explosive, the fuse, the handle, and of course, the pin.
What are you doing?
Simply holds the handle in place. It is only when you let go that this grenade goes boom. Follow me.
It's Gus's actor, isn't it?
No.
Is it supposed to be saying Cuba as well, might be? That's so cool. I really love games that are set in like Resistance Cuba. It probably is!
You will be our president. and our people. They do not know how to be happy. They are torn apart by opinions, noise, indecision, strangled by their own freedoms. And even if you have love in your heart, even if you want what's best for them, if
he's wearing quite modern clothes for Resistance Revolution Cuba, if this is Cuba.
They will hate you, Diego. Everything you say, do, believe, will be wrong.
It'll be set in not Cuba. Ah, oh, okay. Oh, it is Gus Fring! Yay!
They will answer you with screams. Call you evil. A monster. And give you this. So you tell me. Are you evil? Because our country is like this grenade, except it has two basic parts. Our
so impressive computer animation.
And you must clutch them nice.
I'm literally gonna call my dad after this and tell him about this. Because he's such a Far Cry fan. You think they would have shot them by now? They've kind of been out in the open. Nice. Cool. It's too bad it's American. It's backwards. There's no 18th month.
And with that, we're wrapping up our first Ubisoft
Forward. Yeah!
Today, we've seen the
that
next
Far Cry
generation of Assassin's
was
Creed.
Pretty cool.
The birth of a resistance in Watch Dogs Legion. The cyber chaos
Watch
of
Watch Dogs
Hyperscape.
Look cool. I like the idea of London.
And the epic reveal
cool.
of Far Cry's newest installment, along with so much more.
Can I also give credit to the fact
Remember,
that Far Cry haven't done what
year,
all the other games
other
do
Ubisoft
and call it, like, Far Cry the something. They've actually gone for Far
Thanks
Cry 6.
Us.
That's a really bold idea. So basically, in publicity, you don't want to call something like numbered, but they've done it, and that's really interesting. I'd like to know why they've gone for Far Cry 6 and not Far Cry Resistance or something, you know?
Hey everyone, welcome to the Ubisoft Forward post show. My name is Yusuf McGeed, and this is Assassin's Creed Valhalla. We're going to take a deep dive into about 30 minutes of gameplay, and we're joined by a very special guest here.
Hey everyone, this is Philippe Bergeron, otherwise known as Fizz. I am the quest director.
Far Cry New Dawn. Yeah, but Far Cry New Dawn was a spin-off.
So Fizz,
it wasn't in the actual thing.
Like an epic encounter.
You dongus.
Tell us exactly what's going on here.
Yeah, so here we're midway through the quest that we're showing for you before.
Spoilers,
here,
bro.
We're looking at the assault of Burg Castle. So these are big moments that usually sort of culminate at the end of the story. And so here Eivor, our Viking raider, is taking a group of raiders and Ferds into Burg Castle to go and take down Ruid and his clan.
So who exactly
you don't read the
Ruid
chat, do you?
Why does
go Aivor help Tubbo.
Sort of want to pick a fight with him?
I don't know what you're
basically,
talking about.
Basically, Ruid comes into play about halfway.
Okay, Far Cry Primal
was
a genuine one. Fair
Europe,
enough.
This is something
hey, well,
but
I got enough channel points
before.
To highlight my
Ruid
message. I wanted to say thank you for always making me smile. You give off such good vibes. I love your stream. Thank you, man. Thank you for coming down. Thank you for earning enough sub points.
Needs your help to take him down.
Why are they spoiling the game?
Defeated in a previous quest, and so here this is
what happened to
Darkpog.
I took it off. Everyone's complaining.
As you're talking, we're seeing some of the combat.
I need my toothpaste back.
Can you tell us a little bit about the changes to combat this time around?
We wanted to basically add
Omega 706. Thank you for 3 months. Hey, Will, this is my third month subbed. I just want
to
say thank you for everything you've done, and I'll doing you're the reason I wake up every morning. Bloody hell, that's a big. It's a lot of responsibility, man. I'm. Thank you, though. Thank you very much. Annie, thank you for the $1. Well, we haven't forgotten you promising to practice every day from Monday. Yep, tomorrow. From Monday, I will do it. Will the show us home home feed the catchphrase? Catchphrase! Haha! Home home! Give me subs! Do something creative with channel points. Maybe I should. Maybe I should. I don't know. I'm revamping my stream actually, like probably next month, so. It's still gonna have the box and everything you've come to know and love. Ionicity, think of the 2 months. Blaine250, think of the 2 months for home home. The assault, and finally, it's revealed that was Far Cry Blood Dragon actually game? No, that was a spin-off. Oswald, Blood Dragon was another one. Has him captive. So this is what it comes to, Wolfkist? Two Danes fighting over a filthy Saxon whoreson? Wilbur, what pog are you? I refuse to say what pog I am. That is the cringiest shit I've ever.
So now that we've pog seen you. That Oswald is alive, we have Ruid within our sights. What's the next step here?
So the next.
What's your favorite Far Cry game? Two. Far Cry Two is my favorite by far. Then actually no, Far Cry Two, Far Cry Three, and then it's a big gap. Then it's Far Cry Four. Then Far Cry One. Then probably Blood Dragon, actually. Blood Dragon was a lot of fun. A lot of fun.
And it's worth pointing out, actually, that here... What
Will, my mum thinks you take weed. Is this true? Yep, straight into my arms. I pull it back straight in.
To always have a... To support
no,
a
don't do drugs, kids.
Reapproaching these things, so Claire could have approached us a little bit more stealthily and gotten at least like a good.
I'm just saying, if they ruin Watch Dogs Legion or Far Cry 6, so I'm never buying a game again. If that's please. Your play style. Come on.
So we're not only fighting Ruid here, but also his...
Wilbur, should I buy Far Cry? Would you recommend it? Definitely recommend Far Cry 2 a lot. Yeah, go out and buy Far Cry 2. It takes at least one opponent. Far Cry 2 is absolutely phenomenal. I think what I love about Far Cry 2 the most, right, and what people don't give this enough credit, right? So when you pick a gun off the ground in Far Cry 2, there's like almost all of them are rusty, like they're all broken. So yeah, like there's a chance they jam, and you have to like get to cover and unjam the gun. And stuff, and then, but you can obviously buy the clean guns from like the store and things. It's just a really, really good game. Far Cry 2 is just really good. Man. Only the cold dark of Niflheim awaits you. Valhalla is my destiny. That thing will not be met today. Is that the Savannah one? Yeah, Far Cry 2 is the one set in like, I think it's North Africa. It's set. Not treated as equals. I feel like I'm the only one who likes Far Cry 3 more than Far Cry 2. Far Cry 3 is really good as well. Far Cry 3 is bloody good, but I prefer Far Cry 2, man. Will, but you should teach your chat how to pog. That would be cool. Nah, I like them pogging any way they want. Trust me, couple years time, pog is going to become like troll face. It's going to be the cringiest shit, and you're all going to regret using it so much. Including me. I'm going to regret it as well. A lawful assembly.
All right, so we've defeated Ruid.
It was so brave
Oswald.
That in Far Cry 2 they gave you malaria. They did. You used to have to take malaria medication every, like, couple minutes in Far Cry 2. It's such a good game! Oh, Far Cry 2 is so good, man.
So we have this choice to make, but before we get into that, I want to rewind a little bit because we just did this big, grand assault, but Eivor couldn't have done it alone.
Have you watched the Pyro video about Far Cry 3? I have. I'm pretty sure I've spoken with Niall at great length about Far Cry. Me and Niall are big Far Cry fans, dude.
Right. So when coming up to an assault, it's a game of numbers. Eivor can go into pretty much any location.
My pog obsession is so bad. I said pog when the light turned green for me yesterday. Assets,
which ultimately would be a strategy. You can do that. And you'll have some,
what are they showing now? This is Assassin's Creed. It says at the top right of the screen. See right there? Assassin's Creed.
But you still need an army. So here what we're seeing is Eivor going around the
countryside. Thank you and Nikki
and
for inspiring me to start learning guitar. No problem, dude.
The men and
you.
The women of the territory who come up and fight in the name of a king. So here Eivor is going around and trying to convince people to fight in the name of Oswald to finally take down the oppressor that is Ruid.
Defending East Anglia. Defending you. Will you not do the same?
What? In defense of a last cause.
Yeah, so she's really using like the image and like the leadership that Oswald have, what he meant to the people in his name. She's going to recruit these people.
Pretty words, Dane, but the men of Theovard have their own battles to fight.
That's
so we're told by this
Reeve
that there are
That's
troops,
cool
there are allies that he could add to our cause, but first we sort of need to do him a favor. Is that right?
I'm
understand.
Yeah, so obviously these people have been run down.
Are you stopping stream off this post show, or are you going to continue streaming?
So
probably, yeah, I'll continue streaming. I'll read a few more messages and stuff.
That there is hope.
Do you know any other instruments other than string, e.g. piano? No, I don't. I don't know. I play only loads of strings. I play bass, I play mandolin, I play lute, I play guitar, I play double bass. Don't really. If you've got strings, I could give it a good go.
And then get them on your side.
Make more music, please. I will. This is a good time to announce. Hey, chat. Third sequel coming out for I'm in Love with an E-Girl. After Internet Ruined Me, there's another one now coming out. I'm currently in the process of writing it. So it's on its way. And it'll be better than Internet Ruined Me.
When Eivor does this, obviously you have access to a full suite of abilities. So again, the improvements that we've done to the fight system.
What about the Minecraft event? Tomorrow, Minecraft event's tomorrow. It takes a while to set up. It takes like a couple hours to get it all ready, so I can't do it today.
Again, like, depending on what your play style
Internet
is,
room is pretty good though. Thank you, man. It's not very funny though, is it? That's the issue. Internet room, I think it's a good song. It's just not very funny. So. How about if I get the funniness of I'm in Love with an E-Girl and the music of Internet Ruin Me and put them together?
What exactly
that's what I
want
to try and do.
So that is actually this is what we call the.
What time will the Minecraft event be? Probably about 8 p.m. Probably about an hour ago tomorrow.
The Eagle Vision from previous games. And we thought it was good to.
Wilbur should do fish next. I'm doing communism next.
Intuition. It's how she perceives.
And then maybe we give it a break for a little bit. I don't know. I've got other ideas. I want to do loads of ghost hunting stuff.
Basically, interactive objects like things that will bring her an advantage. So.
Wilbur, are you going on a date with Dream? Yes, tomorrow.
Health consumables that are in there. So it really is like a good way of sort of understanding the world and showing you like things that you can go and touch.
About an hour ago tomorrow, please learn to talk. All right, Macy. All right, Macy 290.
Assassin's Creed Valhalla, where we have
a break from events would be nice. Yeah, I like doing audience participation. The thing is, I don't do stuff unless I enjoy it. So like, even though the 5,000 I asked 5,000 people to send me a YouTube video was my best performing video I've done in like months, I still don't want to do another one because it wasn't very fun. You know. So if I can find something that's fun for me to do and helps me, you know, pay for food, then I will do that for you guys as much as you guys want me to, and as much as I want to.
Exploration and discovery. As you travel through the world and you explore locations, you can find these books that will add abilities that you can go and invest in, put into your loadout, then go into the different locations with the different quests.
You're
gonna
carry on doing You Laugh You Lose. Probably one more, one or two more. I don't know. Last You Laugh You Lose, I didn't enjoy very much. It was fun. I did it. That's why I did it for 3 hours. But it was like it just didn't. It just didn't do too well. It was like no one was very funny. So I want to do a You Smile You Lose because it doesn't matter how hard the content is, I will struggle not to smile. East Anglia, I was born East Anglia.
Passion is a virtue suited for anyone, Eivor, including you. Thank you.
Look at Eivor. Look how smug she is. It's like, yeah, I am compassionate. Really angry about that. Being a Norse Viking, Finnis Bob, thank you for the 100 bits. Can you put Karen, I Miss the Kids on Spotify? Yeah, maybe. Denied access to Valhalla. Also, can you remind Eddie obviously that you there? I don't know what that means. I'm sorry. Code name Aquarius, thing with the 2 months. Hey, Wolf, your music content's really helped me cope with a rough breakup and always makes me smile. You're easily my favorite content creator by far. Thank you, Codename Aquarius. I appreciate it.
Oswald and spare Ruud's life, but what exactly is the relationship like between Eivor and Oswald?
So the relationship between Eivor and Oswald is an alliance. It's basically Eivor is surrounded by territories that initially getting into. England,
oh, remind Eddington's solicitors you exist.
And obviously, if
Eddington,
you want to
solicitors.
You want
Eddington solicitors.
So here in East Anglia, Oswald is the man. I've let them know where putting him into. A position of power would help her.
They know I exist. Territory. They are actually in today,
so
I think.
Earlier on to the territory, Eivor comes in here, meets Oswald.
Tell you what, 10 subs and I'll do it again.
Going through the arc, you basically
four melon thing and 100 bits. I'm so excited for the ghost illusion. Thanks, man.
And
mods, can you get a poll going? Should I do it with James Marriott or ghost hunting stream on my own?
We've completed the assault. We've gotten our hands dirty with some combat, taken down Ruud. We have this.
You are going to get kicked
out.
I'm not going to get kicked out.
So before we head off to Oswald's wedding, what do you say we head out, have some fun, and see what we can get into in the open world?
That sounds great.
So we see a cat here with a speech bubble above it, and you best believe
that
if you let
like
me talk to a cat, I'm going to talk to a cat.
Yeah, these are some of our some of my favorite.
Oh, thank you, the Hermit, for the 10 gifted subs.
A bunch of events throughout the territory.
Editor, solicitors.
Sort of again,
I sound like I sound like I've got
a
problem.
It's a chance for us
I sound,
to sort of
I sound like I've got a problem.
A lot of the quests sort of deal with more with like politics and warfare, and this shows a slightly more human
thank
nature.
For the 10 gifted
so
subs, though, the Hermit. Another
10,
I'll do it again.
And so here, basically, like you're trying to help a kid.
Make James bring
his cat.
I'm not making James bring his cat into my office.
Cat to sort of join your crew as a cat raider.
You just said cat raider way too casually. You're telling me I could have a cat Viking raider on my longship?
That's exactly what I'm telling you.
Oh my God! Yes, I love it. Perfect.
So yeah, as you're
that seems like a waste of a slot.
Rivers of England, you would see a cat basically walking around your longship, keeping your Viking raiders company.
Oh, is it like is that like a real thing? Did they do that?
It's
not a thing. Louder next time. Okay, I'll do it louder next time. Is that a real thing?
So starting out
did they actually
project,
have cats in the boats?
I think the
is
Viking
that a thing, or am I
is
going mad?
One of the biggest images that we all have when we think about Vikings in our game, and so Vikings
cat
had this awesome.
I swear that sounds like a good idea. You know, just for like you know morale,
so
get a cat in there.
To go very far inland,
yeah, to eat the mice. I don't think there are very many mice on those longships.
Viking raiders like on. Pretty much any shore. We added that into the game. Where
I'm surprised they didn't tell you to shut the fuck up. They have one. They have one.
Any location, and then just decide to disembark.
Tesco
with
staff, thank you for the 10 months.
Location, loot all his treasure, get back in the ship, and then continue sailing.
Alan,
down
thank
the
you for
river,
the gifted sub to Star Major 64. Wilbur, do not yell. 10
but
subs, and I'll do it louder, dude. That's what I'm saying.
Songs and things like that to be
wait, how many subs
ships
are we on?
Will
how many subs are we on?
Have a similar version of that?
3204
yeah, so
with 300 away. That's
the crew of your
wait,
ship
are we?
To become, like,
let me just quickly check. Let me just quickly check
home
my dashboard because
so
that might be wrong.
Stories and songs
I swear
into
we were.
The ship. So basically, as the player is going around, you could decide to have your skald sort of sing a song for you as you row down the river. But you
yeah,
can
no,
also
with 30, with 3,000, with 60 subs off the Ghost Hunting stream, dude. With 60 subs off, man.
Background who they are, so you get to know your
dude, I'm putting. Hold on. With 60 subs off the Ghost Hunting stream, that's incredible. Where's the sub goal?
So here we're seeing a bit of a different view. What exactly are we looking at?
We had this on previous Assassin's
let me just,
where
let
you
me
would
just
like ride on your horse and you could pull out, have the road the horse sort of follow the track. We have a similar thing for the ship where
we
you
are
can put up your sails. It's cruise control for the ship, so you can pull back, take in the scenery, listen to some songs or some stories, and just take it all in.
So, you know, speaking of Viking songs, we have an activity here that's not exactly singing, but kind of related, right?
Yeah, so here what we have is what we call flighting, which was an activity that Norse people would partake in. They would like to have a battle of
60,
wits
where's Cash
and,
App when you need them? You're right.
Poetry, where insults would be thrown
Finish
back
thing with 100 bits. Can we make it a thing
other
that every 10 or 20 subs you scream, shout, or holler? Maybe a stream where I do that. I don't know. Maybe when I'm ready to get kicked out.
And a good run.
How do you participate in the Minecraft
so
events, Wilbur? So you have to be
a
sub, and during the time of the events, you just come in and chill out with us.
Here's the silver. Now begin.
Oh my god, thank you for all the subs, my dudes. Thank you.
To all those whom I speak, they say Eivor's a clod.
Then you're speaking to fools and their knowledge is flawed.
Well.
How exactly do you go about being successful in one of these?
The trick behind a good flight was to choose the right insult, identifying the right cadence, and then
oh snap
rhyme the best.
Someone write my name in like Scandinavian text. Wilbur. Wilbur.
Silent whispers all claim that you're terribly dense.
What is it? Who is this fucker?
Then you've clearly misheard them. My wit is immense.
Oh, you lucked out with that one.
Who is this?
Well, what a surprise. Eivor of the Raven Clan is a true talent. I'm shocked.
Don't believe everything you hear, unless it touches on my flighting. Then heed every word.
Take the coin.
So now that we
stop talking to this man.
And wit, I think it's time for a bit more relaxing activity.
Wilbur,
so
I'm Swedish.
Here.
Your name is just Wilbur.
Yeah,
oh, okay. What's William or Will? Everyone thinks my name is William
line,
Gold. It's
so
actually just Will Gold. That's something for the wiki page. I'm
fish.
Just Will Gold.
This is used basically.
I always
to,
have been Will Gold, never William.
To play into our new health loop, where the player will lose health in the world, and it doesn't automatically regenerate like we would have in the past. So you actually have to go out and get some supplies.
Fish.
So you'll find mushrooms and some food that you can gather. But here, like you can also catch some fish and consume that to regain some health. We'll sometimes have it in certain quests. So
you can't just decide
to
be called Wilbur. I can and I did. Get on my level.
Just, again, take it all in. So this is what we call one of our offering altars. So the idea is that you find these around the world and you make offerings to it. So it'll take like animal parts.
Mini Mooka, imagine being called
world.
Wilbur. Get out of here, Mini. I need to watch the
here,
video that apparently
seeing,
I'm
sort
in
of
that
like
you've tagged me in.
A
I need to go and watch
fancy version
that.
Of it where as you do your offering, you get interrupted by some kids that basically come and
imagine just changing
your
name. I'm not changing my name. It's just
so
the
just
name I use online.
Sort of
I just prefer
the
name
like
Wilbur. I think it suits me more for my personality. My personality on stream is quite different from my real life personality. Had to get you in the tag somehow. Oh, am I only in it for like a second?
Inside the whole experience.
Yeah, this seemed like a really sort of unexpected turn for what I thought was going to be kind of a simple interaction.
Yeah, and it's really what we were trying to do with
Wait,
these
how far
events
are we off
to,
the,
is to give
how far
another dimension to Eivor, other than just, you know, the pure rar Viking or the politician. Because you can imagine at some point that will grow old if you're always telling that version of the character. So it lets us really go into the depth of who is Eivor, what motivates her,
we're
how she can
up.
Interact
it's
with
the
world
same.
Outside
it's 3448.
Warfare and politics.
Oops. So this is all fake.
Like
no, like obviously my person. I'm just a lot chiller in real life. I'm not as loud.
Just winds the breath.
Wilbur Soot is a lot louder and obnoxious
so
than Will Gold is. Will Gold likes to keep to himself a bit more and be quiet.
They are going through tough times with whatever Ruid's been doing to the territory, and so they're just here trying to survive.
Oh,
and,
Four Melon, thank you for the 5 gifted subs, dude. Tell you what, after this, I'm gonna go on Dream's server. You guys want that?
It was kind of nice to see that Eivor wasn't really necessarily upset at them for stealing, and you know, after you talk to them, you have the choice of helping them.
You guys want me to go on Dream's server just to bully Tommy for a bit?
Or you know, maybe just say, hey, good luck on your way.
Yeah, and then this is something right. We also wanted to do a lot. Like, so here we're doing an event, we do it in quests as well, but we want to give a lot of this agency into players' hands so that they can sort of shape Eivor a little bit, who she is, so it represents them a little bit more. And they can
I asked
play that
the last message
better.
I sent to
again,
the
just gives her, like,
Ubisoft representative
in these
was,
moments.
Can I swear? And they didn't respond. I hope the answer was yes.
Here, large walker.
A necklace?
Yes, it's a Saint Martin seal. You're welcome here anytime,
Do you like
large walker.
Jazz? Do you like jazz?
You're
Do you like
one
jazz?
Of us now. Yeah. Visit us,
it's
okay?
Right.
I will. Take care now, small group.
Wilbur, I saw you at the co-op. I don't go to the co-op. That one guy you saw at
so
the co-op.
I think AC veterans
oh, after the Hobo Johnson
here,
gig
but,
or
what exactly
what?
Is Eivor chasing down?
Yeah, so here you're seeing Eivor running down one of our tattoo images. So this is challenging the player on free run abilities, but also for fans of the series, sort of pulling at their heartstrings for some beloved features.
So are we going to be able to tattoo Eivor?
I'm so sleepy.
Yes. By collecting these tattoos, you actually bring them back to your settlement, and then you can customize different body parts, having different tattoos everywhere. So again, another form
he
of
goes
expression.
Tesco's and I do go
and
Tesco's.
Sort of to represent
Tesco's
that,
is my
that
way,
Viking
man.
Culture.
Is it okay if a fan hugs you if they see you? I'm not a big fan of it, but if it's like a meet and greet, I will, but not just in public. I don't
know. There was no easy way in. And in this case, I saw all the doors were barred, but I knew that because there was a chest in there, there must have been some way to get inside. So I went around the back and, you know, found a way in.
Yeah, I'm glad you actually caught on to that. You're pointing at something that we wanted to work on a lot on Valhalla, where We wanted the exploration.
Would
to
you
make
hug
you
me
feel
while the
smarter,
I think
so
I have hugged you many.
Played
I believe.
A lot with puzzle solving. So
have we not?
Making sure that every house that you find sort of appeals to you, like it draws your attention, and then when you want to come and explore, it's not
right.
given to you. You still have to work for
right.
it a little bit, so it'll challenge you on your observation.
If you want
skills,
to carry on watching,
logic,
just
trying to
Ubisoft
find, how do I
has
get
it on their
this?
YouTube channel. You can go watch it. Just the post show. They're just me showing some clips of games, but I think I'm gonna go and check out Dream Server. If that's chill with you guys, that's what you're up for. You guys down with that? We probbed it. In fact, I think you grabbed my booty, Mini. I would never without your consent, Mini. Should we go see how Dream and Tommy and it are doing? Can't be good, I'm sure. Let's put on some music as well. Right, Minecraft. So you can have a bit of lag for a minute while it boots up. Team, we're talking. I'm literally going on just once to shock them. I just want to shock them. I want to give them a scare. I've left their Discord though, so I don't know how that's gonna go for them. Just in it for the shock value. I'm just in it for the shock value. That's all I'm about. I'm just all about the shock value.
About what?
I'm about the shock value, Tommy. That's all I care about.
How did things go with Dream?
I'm sorry?
How did things go with Dream?
I'm seeing him tomorrow.
Oh.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good, Tommy, innit? Are you live right now?
Yeah.
Hi,
yeah,
Tommy,
innit?
It's you. Do you know I'm also live? You can come watch me.
Okay.
At twitch.tv/Wilbersir.
You know what? Same goes for twitch.tv/Tommy.
You don't want to go see Tommy's one, I'm telling you now. That's just a warning.
No, don't say.
You
no,
don't,
no.
You don't
Wilbur,
want to go watch Tommy.
I'm in a war, a state of crisis.
And who cares?
Well. Okay. Well, yeah, no, yeah, no, you got me.
Oh, yeah?
Turbo has turned on me.
He's as gone he should. To the dark as he side. Should. As he should.
No!
Yeah.
No, no, no. No one should turn on Tommy in it. That's not true.
Who's allowed to turn on Tommy in it?
Only you are, Wilbur.
Okay, well, I'm excited to come turn on you then. Tommy, I just finished watching the Ubisoft thing.
How was
the
it?
Ubisoft. It was actually a lot of fun. It was
How
really fun.
How much money did you make?
How much money did I make? What, off of the sponsorship? Or?
Yeah, just in general.
I don't think I'm allowed to say. I would love to tell you, but I don't think I'm allowed to say.
Do you have a...
It was worth. It was a really good event, actually. It was worth it.
Was it? Listen, Wilbur, between us, was it worth it?
It was a good event. Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
And can I have some of the earnings?
The earnings.
Yeah, the earnings.
Yeah. For what?
Yeah. Just.
Is this your bit? You've gone less funny since I last spoke to you, actually, Tommy. This is strange. I thought you were the funny one.
You know, I'm going to be honest. At the start of your Lava Rising video, Jay Schlatt said that exact same thing, and I was hoping you would find it funny, but he went, how much money did you make, Wilb? And I just, you know, I'm not funny, man.
Can
I
you,
just watch
can
a lot
you,
of
Yeah,
movies.
You should
yeah,
come up with
yeah.
your own joke.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm also stuck in the nether, and I'm really, really concentrating in the... But I'm happy to, you know... Shit's gone down, Wilbur.
Yeah.
Yeah. Should
Hit
I give
the
you the
fan,
rundown?
If you will. Yeah, go on. Give me the lowdown.
Right. It will be very, very, very biased.
Tell you what, I'm gonna stay on the server till I die. The minute I die, I'm off the server.
Okay. Just to preface.
Oh, I need to change my Twitch thing. Hold on.
Fundy's in the wrong.
Fundy's in the wrong.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on, give me 1 second. Hold on.
No. Okay, I'll explain to you what happened. So basically, I tried to give Turbo's B a high five earlier on this stream, and mm-hmm. I didn't realize that when bees sting you, you die. They die, sorry. And then...
Be right back, Tommy. Hi, friend Smile.
Hi, friend Smile.
Hi, friend Smile. How are you, friend Smile?
How are you? Are you trapped, Smile?
I'm in a box. I could probably get out. It's not doesn't look too hard.
Okay.
Let me give it a go. It's protected. I didn't realize till halfway through destroying a block.
Yeah. I'm on my way. Don't you worry about it.
Okay. Yeah. Tommy wasn't on his way to help me. Actually, interestingly.
Wait, Tommy was on his way?
No, he wasn't. He wasn't.
Oh yeah. No. Okay. I was surprised for a second there, but.
Does he not want new people on the server?
Well, no, it's more of like Tommy is currently staying 4,000 blocks away from all of us due to many reasons that have happened earlier.
Oh, would you care to run me through?
So Tommy has a crappy house, Tobo has a really nice house. I destroyed Tommy's crappy house, then Tommy destroyed Tobo's very nice house.
Wait, hold on, I'm getting outspawned on my own.
Yeah, wait, you are?
Yeah.
Why would you... Oh, what the fuck? Oh, okay, this needs to be fixed.
Excuse me, just don't mind me. I'm just... Hey, what are you doing? I'm getting out of here.
Okay, I'll let you do it then.
Yeah, don't worry. I'm an independent soul. Who are all these people? I don't know these people. I don't... Fundy, I only want to be with you, Fundy. Friend Smile.
That's cute, Smile.
I only want to associate myself with Friend Smile.
Okay, let me introduce you real quick. This is Tubbo. You don't care about him. This is Purple. You don't care about him. I'm Fundy. You care about me. Let's go.
Hold on 2 seconds. 1 second. Hold on. Hey, Tommy, hey, were you going to help me out of the spawn?
Why?
I don't know. I was just trapped there. I've gotten out now. I figured I'd just dug my way out. But, like, everyone was telling me I was stuck. So,
Well, see, at the moment, I'm currently taking shelter in the nether because I'm quite worried that I'm going to be stuck when I come back to spawn.
I see. Okay, what did Fundy do to you? Can you explain what Fundy did?
Fundy picked the wrong side of history.
Okay. Cool, interesting. Okay, but be right back, Tommy. Hi, Fundy. Sorry about that. I just had to... Oh, wait. Hold on. I haven't joined. Hold on. I'm awaiting endpoint on the Discord. Hold on. This is justice. Tommy, awkward. I can't join the Discord. It's not working. Hold on. I'm getting him to redo the call. Oh. Hey, Tuff. Hey, Fundy.
Hey.
Hey, sorry. Yeah, I just went to the toilet. What were you saying?
I was saying you don't care about any of these people.
Okay.
You shouldn't care about them. You don't care about them. Let's just leave.
Okay, cool. Okay, where am I going? Where are you taking me?
I am taking you on a little road trip.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have a really cool, nice little road trip. Slightly lost.
Okay. Okay, I see you. So
supposedly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't
Path Pog. Sorry. Carrie, what were you saying? I'm just very excited.
Yeah. So it's this way. Mm-hmm. Just coming over here. Yeah. It's supposedly.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You don't swear on your channel, do you?
I do on Twitch. Fun.
Oh, cool. Nice.
Not on YouTube though.
No, but this isn't
YouTube is
go
PG,
on YouTube.
You know.
You would never go. You would never put this on YouTube.
I would never put this on YouTube.
Mm-mm, no.
No, okay, no. I would never swear or anything like
okay,
that.
Okay, we got a little path.
So this is the little road something, and then here's where most of the fuckery happens.
Okay. Oh, what's happened here?
Well, this is just decoration, I guess. This is like the yeah. You want to? All right. All right, I guess.
Tommy, I'm in the nether.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm in the nether, man.
Okay, I'll come and greet you in a second.
Okay, yeah, come greet me.
What do you think about Fundy?
Yeah, he seemed very nice. He's taking me on a road trip, he said.
I see you're bringing people with you.
I'm not bringing them, they just came with me.
I see.
Yeah, where are you?
I see.
I see you, Tommy. You running away over there. Are you wearing little gold boots?
Yeah, that's me.
Okay, is it alright if I add Fundy into this call?
Why don't we can go to the Discord if you want.
Yeah, send me the Discord invite.
You were in it.
No, I left it because it looked bad.
Okay.
Tommy, I've been streaming an hour and a half. I'm running on empty right now, dude. I don't normally stream this long.
Yeah, me as well. I'm going 2 hours 20. I also don't go this long.
Yeah. Well, just send me the invite.
Yeah,
now.
Yeah. No, I have.
Right now. Oh, cool. Okay, I'll see you there. Bye.
Bye.
He has a bed though.
Hi.
Yeah, we'll have to run by.
Hi there. Hi.
Hello.
Hi there. Hi. Hi there.
Are you a spy, Wilbur Soot?
No, I was just getting both sides of the argument. I don't know. What, a spy for what? I've just got here. I don't even know what's happening.
Okay, I apologize. That was not my intention. I'm just, accusations are being thrown around. I'm just a little confused, okay? Fine. My house has been burnt down.
Purple, protect me.
1 second.
So this is what we're doing.
Why?
What'd you say?
Well, I noticed you two came towards me with swords.
You had
your long schlong, and I can't take any more of that from you, Fundy.
Okay.
If I see another fursuit man with his long schlong running towards me, I will set him on fire.
Actually, it was longer schlong. It's diamond now.
Yeah. Wilbur, you made a good call not joining this.
Is this shovel important?
Yeah.
Don't fuck me over, Wilbur.
The shovel.
Wilbur.
There's many reasons for you to not fuck with that shovel.
Dude, seriously, don't. He loves that shovel. Literally.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Purple. Can you drop me some food?
Don't throw the shovel in the void, please. It has extreme sentimental value.
I will 1v4.
You won't do that.
Dude.
No, come on then, Purple. You want it? You want a bet?
No. Give me a second.
Okay.
Dude.
Wait, actually, can I put on my battle music? Just respectfully, you know.
I swear to God, if you're holding my long schlong, I will get angry.
Guys, I'm gonna need some help over here. Tommy wants to fight me.
No,
and I do not have the fighting gear.
Hey, you remember when you killed me, Purple?
Remember when you killed me, Tommy?
Yeah. Tobo, can you punch me once?
Why?
Just punch me once.
He has one health or something.
Okay. No! Oh my God! Oh.
Why did you push me into the... Why did you knock me into the lava?
That is not what happened. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. No, why am I apologizing? You just destroyed
Why did
shop.
You do that, Tobo?
What? I didn't. What?
What?
Did he have my shovel?
He did. Oh my God. No.
Tobo.
Oh my God.
Tobo.
Fundy, I didn't. I swear. Dude, you set me up.
I mean, it's set. Yeah, I mean, what? I don't know. I don't know this. I don't know the value of it, man. I was just holding it and running around. I told you to punch me, and you just
based on sentimental value.
And you sprint punched me into lava, dude. That's not cool.
I was standing still. If anything, I was in the position to be knocked in because I was gonna jump after it and try to like land on the edge.
I don't know, man. I don't know. You punched me with your shovel into lava. I don't know what to tell you, man. I'm sorry if that had some value to it, but like,
Fundy.
Guys, Tubbo behind you, Tubbo run!
Yes! Dude.
Tommy, you are very lucky that I had nothing of fighting significance.
It just seemed really unfair of you, Tubbo, to do that to me.
Wilbur, I literally...
Tubbo, if you stab me now, you're clearly...
Well, I've had a good time on the server today, guys. It was really nice chatting with you. I'm gonna head out now. Alright, bye-bye. Bye.
Bye, Wilbur.
Do we have a good time on the stream today, guys? I think we had a really good time on the stream today. It's been an absolute pleasure. Spent time. Caitlin, 350k, thank you for the 3 months. Abby, 222, thank you for the $2. If it's okay, I've read that one, but thank you again for the $2. Yeah, it's been absolutely wonderful. Tomorrow, hopefully, we'll hit that sub goal, so we can do the ghost hunt. But yeah, thank you. I'm going to send you over to my friend Fundy. He's in a rough place right now. I need you all to console him. Need you all to make sure he knows who did the bad thing. Make sure he knows that Tubbo knocked me into lava. But yeah, thank you all. It's been absolutely wonderful. Peace out. Bye-bye.